Here are the 5 loadouts for Season 9 and how to play them, presented by FortniteMaster. About 6 months ago, we released a guide on things to consider when choosing your loadout. Unfortunately, it's not nearly as relevant anymore because of how many weapons and items have changed since then, namely the pump shotgun. So, we decided to make another guide with new loadouts for Season 9 to help you guys choose the best weapons and items for your playstyle. Without wasting any more time, let's get started. Before we get started, it's important to know that none of these loadouts are set in stone. Fortnite has a ton of weapons and items, so there is almost always more than one option to fulfill a certain role. For example, using the heavy AR versus the regular AR is largely a matter of preference. Both are effective at mid-range, but the heavy AR tends to be for players who like to take single tap shots, while the regular AR tends to be for those who prefer a fully automatic spray. So, if we mention an assault rifle in the following loadouts, you don't have to choose the exact one we did. You can swap it out with similar ARs if you prefer a different one. Same goes for shotguns. The combat has a significantly higher range than the tac shotgun, but they both fulfill the shotgun role similarly, so choose which one you like best. Just remember that your range is way more limited with the tac. The drum gun, tactical assault rifle, and the burst SMG are all interchangeable too. One thing to keep in mind though, is that the drum gun uses AR ammo, so be wary of your ammo count if you're carrying another AR. Your fifth slot should almost always be reserved for healing. The only real reason not to have healing in this slot is if you simply cannot find any healing items. In that case, substitute an extra utility item. This first loadout is one of the most effective because of how each weapon and item balance each other out. The core of this loadout is the heavy assault rifle, shotgun, and the drum gun or SMG. Together, these three items are one of the most commonly used combinations for any loadout. You have solid mid-range with your AR, and your shotgun swap into SMG or drum gun is great for close range. Finish off the loadout with a movement or control item in the fourth slot and healing in the fifth. The utility in this loadout is a matter of preference. This is the most balanced option already, so any item would work well in the fourth slot, whether that be a sniper, explosive weapon, or some sort of utility. Mess around with it and see what you like best. Playing this loadout is pretty simple. Anytime an enemy is at mid-range or further, take tap shots on them with your heavy AR. If you're accurate, you can usually get a solid amount of damage, even if they're being smart with peeks. We choose the heavy AR for this loadout because it complements the drum gun so well. You burn through AR ammo much slower with the heavy AR because full spraying is horribly inaccurate, leaving that extra AR ammo for your drum gun. And the drum gun has slightly more range than the SMG, so you can use it like a regular AR and full spray anybody who is pushing you. As enemies get close, swap to your shotgun and look for opportunities to chunk them. Once you get an enemy low, pull out your drum gun, take full advantage of that 50 bullet magazine, and spray to your heart's content. This second loadout is for players who love to be aggressive by constantly moving around the map and pushing players. Your AR and shotgun are the main damage dealers here. We'd recommend taking a regular AR over a heavy AR for this loadout because you won't be having an SMG or drum gun. Regular ARs are much more accurate at full spray, and your AR will be your only automatic weapon in this loadout. Note that if you're playing this loadout correctly, you shouldn't be fighting at long to mid range for extended periods of time. The loadout is designed to move around the map quickly and push players. The shotgun and flint knock combo, specifically, is extremely effective if used correctly. The flint knock is probably more versatile than you think. You can use it to be more aggressive by launching yourself up a couple of levels to surprise an enemy on high ground, or you could use it to avoid fall damage. You can also use it as a swap weapon, as long as you're accurate. In fact, the flint knock at close range does just as much damage as your shotgun. Not to mention, flint knock headshots deal more damage than any shotgun currently in the game. We chose glider redeploy as the utility in this loadout because it's the ideal movement item for pushing players and being aggressive. It helps you get from one engagement to the next much faster and protects you from fall damage, so you don't have to worry about building too high or getting shot out. The marksman loadout is for those fans of the boom bow. In the right hands, the bow can be one of the deadliest weapons in the game. It is effective at almost all ranges, does a lot of damage, and is super satisfying to use. With this loadout, the boom bow is your go-to weapon for any mid to long range. The bow is versatile, so you can either camp a position and fight from long ranges, or get yourself some decent damage then push. One tip for peeking with the bow is to draw the arrow before you peek, then just peek for the split second you need to release the shot. Once the fights turn to close quarters combat, you have your trusty shotgun slash drum gun combo to rely on. Look for solid chunk shots with your shoddy, and use the drum gun to rip through builds and finish off your opponents. You have a couple of choices for your fourth slot in this build. We'd recommend some sort of utility like stinks, grenades, dynamite, or even redeploy for more movement. Stinks complement the boom bow well because they force players to reposition. You can usually take advantage of those opportunities to get tags with your bow. Plus, stinks are a great tool to have in general because of how well they counter turtling. Grenades and dynamite serve similar purposes, but don't necessarily complement the boom bow as well as stinks, although they do blow stuff up, so that's a plus. Or, if you're a fan of extra mobility, you could go with glider redeploy, shadow bombs, or even a rift if you have one. Our fourth loadout is perfect for those who prefer sniping over close quarters combat. If one of your favorite things in Fortnite is hitting satisfying headshots with snipers, this loadout is for you. The loadout is built around your sniper, so let's start with that. Ideally, you want a heavy sniper. They do the most damage by far and are the only weapon that can breach any wood, brick, or metal in one shot. The silent sniper does have its value though, because if you're good at hiding it, it can be hard for opponents to tell where you're shooting from. In the end, it'll probably just boil down to whatever you can get your hands on. As for how to play with the sniper, you have a couple of options. You could play more passive and take shots with your sniper from some sort of high ground. Your other option is to look for sniper shots at mid to long range. Then, once you get a hit, push up to finish the kill. If you get a headshot and eliminate them immediately, that's great. But if they don't die, you want to push right away to take advantage of that large chunk of damage you did. We would even consider spraying with your AR while pushing to knock them down and/or prevent them from healing. If you have a heavy sniper, you can use it to breach turtles after dealing massive chunks of damage. This makes it easier to finish off those low health players even if they're turtling. For this loadout, we'd recommend taking a regular AR as it complements the loadout better. You've got mid to long range covered with your sniper. You just need a weapon that can hold its own in that awkward distance that's too close to snipe but too far for your shotgun. The normal AR fits perfectly because it has a more accurate full spray and a higher close range DPS. As for when engagements get close up, use your shotgun like usual and use your AR as a swap weapon. This is yet another reason why the normal AR is better in this loadout, because the heavy AR is a horrible weapon to swap to in close range. For your fourth slot, we'd recommend any movement item like the glider redeploy, shadow bombs, or impulses. This extra mobility allows you to push and escape from fights much cleaner. For example, if you get snuck up on, you could just shadow bomb away and reset the fight to a range where you can snipe. Or, if you land a heavy sniper shot on somebody, but it doesn't down them, you can use your movement item to close that distance before they get the chance to heal up and regain their composure. This last loadout is for those who like nothing better than to blow things up. Pick this one if you love to brute force your way through any fight with explosives and tons of bullets. The first two slots in this loadout are your close range kit, although you have an important choice to make. Your first option is to go with the regular AR and shotgun if you want a balanced pair of weapons. Or you could take a drum gun instead of a normal AR to pair with your shotgun. This reduces your range a decent amount, meaning you won't have any tools to fight for extended periods at mid-range. But what's the explosive expert all about if not pushing aggressively and blowing things up along the way? The 50 bullet magazine on the drum gun also pairs frustratingly well with a bunch of explosives, so consider the possibilities before making your decision. Your third slot is for your explosives. Ideally, you want to find a grenade launcher or a rocket launcher for this slot. Both are great tools for pushing and bombarding enemies with explosives, but let's start with the rocket launcher. You have a little more control with this weapon's projectiles than the grenade launcher, but they work similarly when pushing. Simply shoot rockets at an opponent's build while you're pushing, so they'll have to focus on rebuilding or repositioning rather than shooting you. Once you get into close range, try taking and holding high ground with your rocket launcher. You'll be surprised how many free rockets you'll hit on players trying to build up. You can push similarly with grenade launchers. Shoot grenades at their builds to distract them while you push up. But since grenade launchers are almost useless in close range, consider stopping once you find that sweet spot where your grenades are landing on their head. Empty your clip from that sweet spot, then continue pushing to capitalize on the damage that you hopefully dealt. For your fourth slot, you have a couple of options. You could take a movement item and use it to help close the distance on enemies faster. This is even more valuable if you choose the drum gun over a regular AR and can't fight mid-range. You could also take some sort of control, whether it's stinks, boogie bombs, or more explosives. Stinks are always a great option, especially for finishing off weak enemies. Boogie bombs pair really well with rocket launchers because they basically give you a free shot. And of course, more explosives is rarely a bad thing. Play around with it and see what fits your playstyle. Thank you guys for watching this video. For those who are new to the channel, if you've enjoyed this video, check out some of the others on the right side of the screen. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell to get notifications for whenever a new guide shows up. Thank you again so much, and doubly so if you shared it with anyone else like your friends, family, or your pets. From over here at Fortnite Master, my name is The Saved One, and we're out. Peace.